Project Economy Now keeping track of issues affecting your pocketbook.
And Pittsburgh's mayor is now looking to tax sugary drinks, from sweetened tea to soda to chocolate milk, even energy drinks. Channel 4 Action News anchor Michelle right here now. Michelle, the mayor really pushing hard for this.
Oh, yes. In fact, so hard he's going to go to Harrisburg on Monday to talk with legislators about how to implement this. He got the idea when he saw that Philly was considering it. But I talked to the owner of a local company who told me that a 2 cents per ounce tax would just about double the price of what he sells.
So this is a gallon. So what would this be taxed at?
The tax would be $2.56 a gallon.
Just the tax.
That's about what the iced tea costs.
Chuck Turner said the tax would have a huge impact on his sweetened iced tea, which is about 40% of his business. But Mayor Luke Ravenstahl says the city must find $15 million to deal with its pension fund, and doing nothing is not an option.
The city needs help, that everybody has a role to play, and doing nothing is going to be worse for their business and the image of Pittsburgh than the sugary drink tax would be.
The mayor also suggests it should be considered a health initiative, that cutting out sugary drinks would benefit our waistlines.
If somebody has a better idea or a different idea on how to generate $15 million, we're all ears.
But this third-generation owner of the Penn Hills Dairy Farm says 2 cents per ounce is just too much.
2 cents an ounce, for example, on a 16-ounce iced tea is 32 cents. This product only sells for 69 or 79 cents out of store as it is.
Turner says he can't imagine that this will pass because right now there's no tax on coffee or tea, and there hasn't been since the Boston Tea Party.
Nobody in this country has taxed iced tea since the English tried to tax tea in Boston in 1773.
And Turner told me we might have a Pittsburgh tea party if this passes. But Turner says the low-fat chocolate milk that he makes is good for kids, and he doesn't understand why the mayor would consider putting a sin tax on it. By the way, diet drinks and fruit juice would be exempt in this.
Now, Mayor Ravenstahl said he got the idea when he heard that Philadelphia was thinking about this. Any other cities around the country considering this?
Well, yeah, Philly is considering it. New York, California, Colorado are among 7 states also considering it. Chicago is the actual only major city with a sweetened beverage tax at 3% right now. So we'll see. We'll let you know next week what happens.
This will be debated. Thanks, Michelle.